I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I'm not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Verse 12. Whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor and gather his wheat into the garner, but he will burn off the chaff with unquenchable fire. Mark 1:8. I indeed have baptized you with water, but he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost. No fire here. Holy Ghost. Luke 3:16-17. John answered, saying unto them all, I indeed baptize you with water, but one mightier than I cometh, the latchet of whose shoes I'm not worthy to loose. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. John 1:33-34. And I knew him not, but he that sent me to baptize with water, the same said unto me, upon whom thou shalt see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, the same is he which baptizeth with the Holy Ghost. So Matthew and Luke said Holy Ghost and fire. Mark and John said Holy Ghost. All right? So in Acts chapter 1, when Jesus now referred to John's baptism, Jesus did not include fire. Why? Fire talks about the judgment for people who reject the gospel. Fire is a symbol of judgment. That if you do not believe the gospel, there's a day coming when the door of salvation will be shut and you will be exposed to judgment. That's the fire. So when Jesus spoke, he separated Holy Ghost baptism from fire. So when Brother Paul will now talk of John, he said, John baptized with the baptism of repentance, talking of Christ who will come. That is how to look at the prophets. So the words of the prophets must be interpreted, because when they say Holy Ghost and fire, the interpretation will be, today we have Holy Ghost baptism, which is being born again. But fire is judgment for people who reject Christ. So their words must be rightly divided. The prophet's words must be rightly divided.